welcome back to another episode of The Square Room. New episodes every single Tuesday. My name is Jonelle, and I'm here with my co-host, Eugene, and Des Wayne.
Hello. Hey. Hey.
How you doing?
I'm alive.
That doesn't answer the question, but I'll take it. Des?
I'm great, actually.
See, that's an answer.
Thanks, because I'm really good.
Yeah.
How are you?
I am decent.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, something happened again. So a couple weeks ago, I told the story on the podcast of like this random person who was trying to track me down on the internet. For those of you who are listening and you're not exactly sure sure what I'm talking about, the brief recap is some person who I didn't know was trying to contact me by messaging an acquaintance of mine on Snapchat. No, that would be creepy because then they would have my address. No, this guy messaged an acquaintance of mine on Snapchat. I guess it said, you know, friends of friends or mutual, whatever. Like, I don't even use Snapchat that much anymore, which is, I guess, why he couldn't get a hold of me.
Send me a dick pic.
She sent me the details. She sent me his Snapchat name. So I messaged him. I was like, hey, are you trying to get a hold of me? He was like, yes, blah, blah, blah. Long story short, he is someone who self-proclaimed, I'm not being like full of myself, but he said he was a fan of mine from like when I used to make YouTube videos, which I currently do not. It's been a few years. So he was just kind of like, oh, you know, where have you been? Why aren't you making videos? When are you going to come back? Like, it was nice. And I, you know, told him I appreciate it. But like, hey, like the way you went about it, like it was really sketchy. Like my friend didn't appreciate it and I don't either. He was like, okay, cool. Got it. Right. That's where we left off a few weeks ago. Well, a few days ago, I get another message from her and she was like, hey, so this guy is messaging me again. Actually, let me backtrack a little bit. So obviously, I had a brief conversation with this guy, as I just mentioned, and this conversation happened over Instagram. He, at some point, like, I guess the thing just, like we weren't, like, talking every day, but, like, the message that I have in my, like, inbox, his name changed, and I suppose that his Instagram was, like, deleted or blocked or whatever, because I got a message request from, you know, like when someone doesn't follow you, but like whatever. When you don't follow that person. Yeah. And he was like, hey, it's me. Like, I don't want to say his name.
It's me. Eduardo.
No. He was like, hey, it's me. Like, you know, my Instagram got deleted. This is my Instagram. And it's funny though, because that same account, that the new account that he's messaging me from, it says the first message I got from him was back in August. So he's been trying to contact me, but I didn't see it. And, this one, I'm like, okay, you know what? I've already spoken to you. I've already acknowledged you. I'm not adding you. I'm not following you back. I'm not accepting this message. Whatever. So I guess now that he had no way of contacting me since his Instagram that he was able to talk to me through is deleted or whatever, and I'm not adding the new one, he went back to message this friend. And I was like, ugh, what the fuck? So she sent me a screenshot of like their conversation. Because, like, he started messaging her again, but it's from his new account. So she was like, wait, who is this? Like, what's your name on Snap? And he was like, when I came, I asked about Jonelle, and you blocked me. Can you remove the block, please?
Oh, boy.
And she was like, why? She's like, this is mad sketchy. What is it that I can help you with? And he was like, can you tell Jonelle to reply to this account, please? Only do this thing for me. Will you tell her, please? Because you're the only girl who is replying to me, so that's why I'm telling you.
So there's multiple?
Right. That's what I'm like. How many of my people are you messaging? They, like, the people who know me probably think I'm so sketchy.
Yeah, I'm sketchy, bro.
I don't know this man from anywhere.
He knows like, you.
He knows me. And, like, I made the mistake of having a brief conversation. And, like, now that the conversation has stopped, he's trying to,
he's
like,
still trying to get a hold of you.
I'm like, are you kidding me? I'm like, this, I'm for sure not opening that door again. Because last time he messaged her, the message came through to me, and he, you know,
it
was successful.
A little bit better, so he's gonna try it again.
Right. So now I'm like, I'm not rewarding this behavior.
Too late.
I know. I'm not rewarding it again. It's sketchy. I don't like it. It's really creepy. And the fact that, like, I did tell him that both she and I didn't appreciate it, and he's still doing it. Like, I know I said this before, but y'all, if you're trying to get a hold of, first of all, like, just contact the person, and if you can't get a hold of them, that's it. Unless you, I think the only time it's acceptable to like go through someone is if it's someone you know in real life. If I'm like, hey, Hugh, I haven't heard from Des in a while and I can't get through, would you mind passing on a message? That's different, because you're an asshole, you'd say no. But like, I know Des in real life, so it's different, and then that's for Des to accept or not. But like, for someone you don't know, like, it's just, it's creepy. And like, she's just like, girl, you need to be careful because he's really sketchy. And I'm like, I know. The only reason I'm not super scared is because he said he lives in Qatar. He lives in a different country. Mm. So, I mean, who knows? That may not even be the truth, but.
He's looking at you right now.
He's like, I can see.
He's looking at me
right now.
Was it Eugene this whole time?
It is me. My name is Ahmed.
Oh, okay.
Boy.
Jesus.
What?
Oh boy.
I don't know.
Yeah, it's like really bad stereotypes. But yes, so, you know, I just have a crazy fanboy trying to track me down.
That makes sense.
Really,
I want a fangirl or a fanboy. I don't care.
Yeah.
I want to get tracked down too.
No, you don't.
I can defend myself.
It's not about that. It's just annoying.
Yeah.
And it's, the worst part is, it makes, it's, would be one thing if like the messages were just coming to me and I'm like, oh, it's annoying, but let me ignore them. But like, when he's going to people in my life who have like, you know, like, oh, this person also follows Jonelle and Jonelle follows him back. Like, now, and the fact that, I don't know, he implies that he's messaged other girls. Yeah. 'Cause he's like, you're the only girl that will respond to me. So that tells me that he's messaged at least one or two others about me, and she's the only one who's ever gotten back. So that's, I'm like, damn, I wonder how many people are just like
ignoring it completely.
Yeah, but like, I wonder if like he's like actually said my name to them.
Probably not.
I would hope so. I would hope not. But like, either way.
Because they would have came back and been like, some random weirdo tried to message me and ask me for you.
Yeah, you would think, right?
You'd read like the message and then go tell the person.
Yeah. But that's the thing. Not everyone who follows me and who I follow back, I know in real life. Some people are like internet friends.
That's true.
I have other people that I did meet and connect with, females, women, who, when I was like making YouTube videos, they were a fan of mine and I liked them back. So like, I follow them back. So like, maybe he's messaging like randos, you know?
That's true.
Like, it doesn't mean that they're like, I don't know. I don't know. Either way, super sketchy. Don't like it. Don't do it. And the first time I talked about him on the podcast, I was like, hey, you know, I don't want to say anything bad. Like, he's a nice guy. Like, he's just a fan.
That's your problem.
What?
You fucking give the benefit of the doubt.
Well, I think it's good to give the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah, that's how you get fucked up.
I don't want to be one of those jaded people who, like, if someone is like, hey, like, I like what you create. And he was like asking, he's like, oh, like, when are you going to make videos again? Like, why did you stop? Like, they were questions that I was fine with, you know? What? But I guess even the fact that I had that conversation, he took it in his head as like, we must continue to speak.
He's like, I gotcha, bitch.
Yeah.
This was genuine.
Horrible, but accurate. There's also some stuff that's been happening recently in the news.
I like news.
Hugh, I would love for you to explain yourself.
Oh, what happened?
You made the news.
I did?
Yeah, you're a mailman, right?
Sure.
For a big Canadian,
what? There's only one.
Postal service.
I don't know.
I got what you mean.
What happened?
You're a Canadian mailman, correct?
Yeah.
Well, a Canadian mailman.
Huh.
Maybe it was you, maybe it wasn't.
Uh-huh.
Delivered a rifle to an 11-year-old.
Oh, that was in Ottawa.
I know, it's a joke, Jesus. Obviously it wasn't you. I would hope you wouldn't be that dumb. Don't laugh, because I think you need to explicitly say, no, I would never.
No, he didn't really necessarily deliver it to a 12-year-old. He probably just...
11.
He wouldn't know what the package is.
That's the thing, right?
Unless like Remington on it.
That's what I was gonna say. People are stupid.
Well, hold on, because he did know that it was something that needed to be delivered to someone 18 plus and required a signature. That's what it said, and it said 18 plus, and you get, and I think an 11-year-old, you know that they are not 18 plus.
Yeah. No, so how the rule is?
A 12-gauge shotgun.
Hey, you gotta do what you gotta do. Well, how it is for us right now? If it's something that's 18 plus, it normally automatically gets carded, so I don't know how the person was able to deliver it, but
it wasn't even going to that. So it was wrong address, first of all.
Oh, that's a best suspension right there.
Right. So it's wrong address. Then it said 18 plus, and so you gave it to a 11 year old.
Doesn't matter. Yeah. It doesn't matter. If whoever answers the door, they sign it.
And then apparently the employees blamed the child for opening the box.
100%, because now you actually are opening up somebody else's mail, which is illegal. Yeah, that's
fraud.
Well, yeah. But the kid doesn't...
I don't want to hear that.
When he tried to deliver it, he didn't verify the age, obviously, and didn't ask for ID, and the kid said there's no...
No one ever does.
He said there's no adult who can come to the door right now, and he just handed it over.
Yeah, that's what we do.
No.
But that's literally what we've been trained to do.
Proof of age is required when shipping firearms.
He's not going to know if it's a gun. This is a long box. Unless it said like Remington and he's a gun guy or some shit. Yeah,
I wouldn't know it's a gun.
Yeah, I wouldn't know. If it's like Remington or like Bushmaster or some shit, I would know.
Bushmaster.
But like, the guy's not going to know. A person that's not a gun guy is not going to know.
Well,
I've delivered guns before this.
I had no idea that you could order guns in the mail. How do you think
they ship them?
No bueno.
Yeah,
like it's one thing if like a company is ordering like shipment into their store. I can just order a gun to my house.
Yeah, you can order chickens too. We deliver chickens
live.
Yes, we deliver chicks.
Oh, like little baby chicks.
Yes, I've heard. I've had.
How do you deliver them? Not in boxes.
Yes, in a box. The box has a bunch of holes in it.
Oh, I was like, those are corpses that you're.
And you know, because you just hear like, you're like, oh, I'm chickens.
Oh my god, the way you guys are so rough with packages, though, you like throw them.
No, we know.
At my mom's house,
I've delivered to chickens before. Yeah.
You have?
Yeah, like a while ago.
The neighbor behind us, we have like one of those fences that are just wires and you can see through it. They have chickens in their backyard, just kind of like. Running around.
When I used to work in the West End, there's a guy who had chickens. Probably not until I have kids. I've been more honest with myself about it because, like, but if I go on vacation,
that's still that you want them.
Yeah.
What do you mean if you go on vacation?
Because who's going to take care of the chickens if I go on vacation?
Oh, so you want to go on vacation and leave your kids? You don't want to go on a family vacation. Chicken.
Of course. What the fuck else are they for?
He's like, fuck family vacations.
So when you say your kids, you mean
wait? So you want to have kids to watch the chickens?
No, the kids to be grown ups and let them watch the chickens.
Who said about anything more gross? I'm not going to let these parents. You're 12. You can.
You're going to leave your 12-year-old.
I have a
go on vacation.
I have a wife.
So you're going to leave your whole family.
Yes.
What?
He's like, you thought they were coming?
Everyone's like there with their bags packed. He's like, oh, you thought I meant.
Where the fuck you think you're going? This is a solo trip, bitch.
But daddy.
That's crazy.
Oh, not your dad.
And you want them to watch your chicken? No. I'm not watching your chicken.
What wow. I got kids for? Shit.
No. Well, literally, yeah. That's why you have kids.
Yeah, I want to have chickens and stuff to have kids.
Can you imagine? He's like, damn, you know, I got to have kids. Who's going to watch the fucking chickens?
The fucking kids.
Wow.
Unless, like...
Not even your wife. Not even, like, a weekend getaway.
He's leaving the kids to watch the chicken.
He's like, don't you
the
understand?
Wife
I
want to
get away from all of you.
Yes.
It makes sense. She doesn't have to watch the chickens because she'll get upset.
No, she watches the kids.
And the kids watch the chicken because they have to do what daddy says. Yeah, that makes sense.
Oh, God.
No, I told myself, like, when I have a family and stuff, my birthday present will be leave me alone.
Every year.
Get the fuck out. Leave me
not
alone.
Not just your birthday. Anything. Father's Day, Christmas.
Yeah, Father's Day would be a good part. Like, just leave a cake and fuck off.
Leave a cake.
Don't even enjoy it.
Do people
it with
get
me.
Cakes to themselves for Father's
He will.
Day?
He will. He knows what
it's
he
my
wants.
Fucking day.
He's like, I don't want a fucking tie and tools. Give me a cake and get the fuck out.
I want to buy some tools.
They're going to give him a cupcake. What the fuck is this?
Like, Daddy, can I have a slice? Are you a father?
As he unwraps it and shoves it down his throat.
You fuck.
You're horrible.
No, I'm great. I'm providing you.
Your
eggs.
Kids are going to grow up with daddy issues and you're still going to be in the house.
Yeah, you're going to be around.
Someone's going to be like, Eugene, I saw your daughter and she's gonna whore. Like, she's sleeping around. You'd be like, oh, well, blame the father. Like, sir, that's you. God.
Yeah, we do. Yeah, the gun, yeah, you won't know. But, like, they're delivering to the wrong house. That's wrong. But, like, no, yeah, I don't know how he delivered, because, like, how our system is right now, unless it's different in Ottawa, but I doubt it is, if we scan something that's 18 plus, it's automatically carded.
Well, it says so that's what I don't get. They think that at some point during the delivery process, a loose shipping label got affixed to the parcel by accident. That's their.
Even like, if it was 18 plus, it still would be carded. As
to why it was delivered to the wrong address.
I was like, bullshit.
But what they did, they sent the kid a care package because he was, like, traumatized. Cause,
oh, fuck off.
Tell the parents to shut the fuck up.
Oh, hey, what a care package, kid. You saw a fucking gun.
You're still going to have it in your mind even if I send you this.
Oh, Dad, I saw a shotgun. I don't know what to do. Fucking hell, man.
First of all, that could be traumatizing.
You see a gun?
Yeah, because maybe the kid is like, oh, God, is this a threat to my family? Like, you don't know how he took it, right? Like, but
me sending you a care package is not going to do anything about that.
What did CPO send?
I don't know. They didn't,
sorry?
They didn't disclose.
Did more for that kid than they did for us.
Fuck. They didn't disclose, like, what they put in the care package, but they did share the letter.
PS5.
So they said, hi, blank. No, they're not going to pay that.
Yeah. Give me a $10 Tim's card.
Probably. They said, hi, blank. We are the leadership team at Canada Post. We know that you feel badly about what happened on Monday with the parcel that was wrongly delivered to your home, but you should know that there is no reason to feel this way because you did nothing wrong. Adults make mistakes sometimes too, and boxes are meant to be opened. It's fun to open boxes and discover what cool things might be inside. Yeah, I have to read it like 11. I have to read it like that because like that's they're really talking like he's like 7 or less. 5. Yeah.
Insulted if I was a little bit. What the fuck do you think this is?
The box on Monday was not so fun, but we hope that this one makes you smile. We think that you rock, and you must be an awesome person. Stay awesome. Smiley face emoji with the fucking sunglasses.
Probably that's all that was in the fucking box.
Just that letter. Just the letter. On the back, this was fun, right, bitch?
Can you imagine? He's like, the fuck is this?
No, trust me, I know these people, man. That's all that was in the fucking box.
Yeah, it says, no, a care package is supposed to include, like, a couple
Sharingan.
There's probably some stamps, a pin. And that was
It probably was a stamp. Like, it's probably, like postal.
We fucking got.
Someone sounds a little salty.
Quite, no, it's fine. No, I don't. Yeah, the guy probably. Yeah, if that guy's just probably suspended. Because he delivered to the wrong house.
I'm sure it was an honest mistake, but he was careless.
Fired. He does this all the time. Fired.
Okay, it's like, all right, John, this is the 4th shotgun this week. Come on. All right. I learned a new word this week.
Bobble gag.
No.
Bobble gag.
That's actually.
I haven't learned that one. What's that?
It pretty much means like bullshit, essentially. It's like a bullshit document. It's like a nothing burger.
Oh, my mind went somewhere completely.
It's like a nothing burger. So it's like you know when like sometimes when people ask like a politician the question, but they don't answer the question, they just say a lot of stuff. You know when someone says a lot of stuff, but they don't say anything?
Bobble gag?
Yeah.
Are you sure you're not mixing up with the term lollygag?
No. Google it. It's bobble gag. Essentially, is when Google someone it. Essentially no, is no, either no. Like a document, but or like there's like two. It's like the British way, I think, is a document, and I think like a document that's supposed to say something, but it doesn't actually answer anything. Mm. And I think the American way is like I'm answering a question. You ask me a question, and I just say stuff, but I don't actually do the question. I'm just saying a lot of nothing. Essentially,
interesting.
So,
what's it called?
The bobble gag.
Wow. Well, something so then like maybe that. I learned two new words this week.
Something like that, yeah. Bobble gag.
Nice. No, I haven't heard of that. Yeah, like when you're like you're saying a lot of words, but you're not saying anything.
Shit.
Yeah, it's both like a blessing and a curse because if you do it on purpose, it's a skill.
Most people do it on purpose,
but if you do it, yeah, but if you do it and you're not trying to, then it's like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Even when you do it on purpose, you're like, shut up.
Okay, this is not it.
That's what? Not it.
A lot of porn is popping up.
Well, that's so when he
bisexual
said
bisexual swinger.
When he said bobble gag, I'm like, well, you bobbling gag? And gagging on the dick, what like is bobble gag? that's where my mind went.
Bubble gag. Not bubble gag.
Yeah, maybe you need to enunciate. Bubble gag.
I can't say it properly. Something like that. I'm probably gonna.
So maybe you're like mixing up a word.
I'm maybe saying it wrong.
Probably.
There's something along the
line. So maybe I didn't learn another new word.
Well, you learned your definition.
The word that I learned was death grip. Particularly penis death grip. Are either of you familiar?
Is it somebody's vagina?
No.
No, I don't know what death grip is.
Okay, so I found out. Don't ask me how I found out. I found out that a penis death grip is essentially when someone is used to masturbating very hard and furiously, usually because, like, they live in a household where they're, like, required to do it very quick, like, before getting caught, or, you know? But what that means is that in the future, when they have a partner, nobody can mimic that feeling, and they're left always being, like, unsatisfied, because, like, regular sex with another person doesn't have that death grip.
So Blue Chew's for?
No, because Blue Chew and, like, those other type of supplements, Viagra, all of that shit, Cialis, those just keep you erect. That doesn't mimic the feeling of the death. Like, you're just talking about, like...
essentially, you fuck yourself up.
Right. Like, okay, for instance, both of you guys come from families with other, like... not a lot, but, like, other people in the house. Like, I'm an only child, so it was just me and my parent versus you guys both had, like, brothers, like, other people who could walk in on you.
Aunts, uncles,
Well, I don't know about Hugh. Well, but, like, you know what I mean? What I'm saying
I didn't have that problem.
You guys had... No, but, like, you guys had that possibility.
Yeah. Oh, I had that problem.
I didn't have that problem.
No, they left you alone?
No, I just know what to do. I just know how to do it.
Did you ever have to... did you ever have to, like, crank one out real quick?
Like, out or hold it in real
quick? No, like, basically, did you either of you guys ever have to masturbate, like, quickly because you were gonna get... No, never. No.
Yeah, wow. I gotta do this shit at work. Yeah.
I think it's also different because, Hugh, you're the youngest versus Des, you're the oldest. Yeah, so, like, the older ones don't really bother... Once they get to bother that age, bother you, whereas the little ones are always bothering the older ones. So maybe that makes more sense.
Yeah, that makes sense. A couple years ago, I went to my mom's and... This is when I did not live there. No, I lived there, actually. I went downstairs. I was going downstairs. And as I'm going downstairs, my brother's like, no. Don't come down here. I was just like, okay. And I went upstairs.
The youngest one?
I wish. No, Dwayne.
Right? Don't, had you don't to have be to him. Say his name.
I do.
Jeez.
I do.
Dwayne!
Dwayne! And then he... Ew, Hugh. I didn't pay no mind. Whatever. You're beating your meat. You're beating your meat. That's fine. Okay. And then he came upstairs.
I love
that
you automatically knew.
Yeah.
Because, like, I feel like me as a girl, I'd be like, why? What's wrong? Like, you know?
It's funny you say that because I was with a girl and she was just like, why can't we go down there? I'm like, because he's probably masturbating. And she's like, what?
I want to see.
And I'm like, what does it matter? You know, you say don't come down here. Okay, respect that.
True, yeah.
You know, he was there. I don't care what he's doing. He came upstairs and tried to, like, fist pump me. And I'm like, don't touch me. Like, I didn't see you wash your hand or nothing. And he just started smiling. I'm like, no. Like, I'm not smiling with you. You nasty.
Yeah,
but
wash your hands.
My thing is, in order for that to happen, you have to be butt ass naked to tell someone, no, don't come down here. Don't come. Oh, my God. Don't come down here. Don't and I come, say that because as a guy... When you hear someone coming, your first reaction is, you know, throw the blanket over you. Act like you're doing something else, you know? You pretend that you're not doing anything. For you to scream no is either you're just about to ejaculate and, like, there's no point in grabbing anything, or you are, like, butt-ass naked, standing up in the middle of the room, like, having a jerk party with yourself.
Now, if I'm just jerking off in the bathroom, I'll just, like, flush the toilet.
Right, but so you're in the bathroom. No one's ever like,
Eugene. No, I'm taking a shit. Fuck off.
But, like, other people have to wait for the bathroom. No. Did you have a bathroom to yourself growing up? When you were a kid?
No, but there was a downstairs bathroom. No one really. But I didn't jerk off in the bathroom when I was a kid. I just jerked off in my room.
Oh, you do that now?
Now I'll probably.
Oh, really? Whose phone just went off? You guys always give me shit when it's me. It's it used to always be Hugh. Then he caught on.
Because my phone is on Do Not Disturb, but because.
And you got disturbed.
Yeah, because he can pass that.
Who's that?
Jade. He's with Kaden, so.
Oh, so then maybe you should answer because he would know that you're.
No. Nobody remembers my life, so it's okay. I had to sit behind my door one time because I was masturbating on the floor in my room. I was maybe 13. And I remember this. Anyways, I used to masturbate with my laptop. So my laptop's on my knees and my dick is out and I'm beating my meat. Ooh, yeah, this is good. It's on mute.
Wait, hold on. You're sitting on the ground.
Mm-hmm. Laptop is on my knees.
So your knees, are your legs on straight or like bent?
Straight.
Okay.
And the laptop's just sitting there. My back is against the wall. I'm just beating my meat.
Me and Hugh are like painting
a picture. Yeah. Because I don't want it too close and I don't want it too far. So it's on my knees.
So, right, because at first I thought, like, your knees were up. So, I'm like, what are you reaching around? No,
they're flat.
Yeah, okay, makes sense.
So, I'm sitting there, and I'm beating my meat, stroking my day. I'm sitting beside my door. So, now I hear my grandma knock once, and I jump behind the door. Like, sorry, I slide over, and my back is against the door, and she tries to push the door. And she's like, what are you doing? So, I'm trying to, like, fumble between pulling up my shorts, making sure the laptop doesn't come, you know, the volume start playing, and closing it without her seeing it because the door's kind of open. And she is pushing this door open. And I have to, like, put my foot against the wall. I'm like, Grandma, I said I'm coming. She's like, what are you doing in there? I'm like, nothing.
You're changing or something.
No. I've showered you. You know how black people get when they want to get somewhere? I used to bathe you.
You said you were 13.
I used to bathe you.
I would be, no.
At 13, yes, but that's not what they're thinking in your head. Kaden's 11. If Kaden is like, don't come in, I'm naked. Boy, please.
Really? I feel like I'd be like, no. Like, no. I'd be like, okay. It
fucks up your kid's sense of boundaries.
It does. Yeah. There's no boundaries.
No, I wouldn't. Fucks up once I'm no longer bathing you, then you have a right to privacy. I mean, even when you're little, you have a right to privacy. But you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not currently seeing you naked. You're growing up. Your body's changing.
The only time
I want to fucking see that shit. You don't want me to see it. You have
privacy is in the bathroom. The bathroom is the only place I believe is your private time. Anywhere else? No.
No. What?
No. I will knock out of respect.
But
you cannot tell me, do not come in your room. What do you mean, don't come in your room? So that's like saying your child could be in there playing with guns, drugs. You don't know.
No, because they're acting so frantic. But it's like, okay, like, if your kid is like, don't come in, I'm naked, you're still gonna walk in? No.
But I didn't say I was naked. I'm not gonna say I'm naked. I didn't know what to say. I was masturbating.
But you just gave that example that, like, if Kaden did that, you're like, oh, I don't care.
I'm coming in.
Right. So I'd be like, put on clothes, I'll be in 1 minute. So if you're playing with guns, well, first of all, my kid never, because I'm gonna be a better parent than that.
You say that. Nah.
Unless mailmen like you are dropping off guns to my kids.
Already, you can't say it, right?
Not Gunwood.
But I'm still going. Like, I don't care.
No, I wouldn't. If my kid's I'm naked, I'm like, all right, put on clothes.
If you say you're naked, fine.
But I'm not going to give them, like, if I'm coming in, I'm coming in. But I'm like, okay, put on clothes.
And, like, when my grandma didn't say anything, I was just like, no, you can't come in here. I said I'm coming.
No!
Yeah, I don't believe on, like, locks on the doors when they're young.
How young is young?
Well, like, there just wouldn't be a lock on their door.
Kids will never have a lock on the door.
Ever.
Because I'll just break it. Get an axe.
You will not have a lock.
I was trained in opening doors, kid.
Not in my house.
But I will respect.
You don't think I know how to do this?
But a closed door, I will not. I'm not just walking in on my kid.
No,
I don't
of course
like that.
Not. You don't walk
that.
In. I'm a one knock.
Dad, I'm doing coke.
I'm not even laughing. Can you imagine? I can't. I can't imagine.
Like, fuck off, Dad.
Did you guys see the girl on Instagram freaking out because her dad won't give her more money to buy coke because she lost her money?
What?
She was on the ground, and I'm talking about, she's maybe 18 plus, and she's freaking out, screaming.
Is she, like...
It's called,
Or is she...
Come on now.
What does that mean?
Is she...
I don't get it.
Okay, you don't need to get it.
Yeah, it's okay.
What does that mean?
But she's exactly what you think she is. And everyone was laughing around her. She's like, it's not fucking funny. I just want my drugs. And her dad's like, I'm not doing this. And he just walked away.
It's called an addiction.
I'm like, that's crazy. And it's crazy that they're just laughing and like it's a joke. I'm like, this is crazy.
It's time to put your kid in rehab.
Yeah. Long time ago.
So, okay. So because you had to somewhat death grip yourself, mm-hmm. do you feel like it has made you not completely desensitized, but you know what I mean? Like, do you need more stimulation?
Oh, 100%. But it's not because of that. It's because I masturbate way too much.
But maybe that's when it started, though. You know what I mean?
No, you got to really fix it. You just gotta go cold turkey for like a.
No, I know, but I
can't. But like to fix it, you just go cold. You just gotta go cold turkey for like a good year. It's hard as fuck, but you gotta do it.
I think the problem is it's people who have this issue. It's not that other forms of like intercourse is not enjoyable, but it doesn't like get them there. You know what I mean?
What they need is therapy and cold turkey.
And I also don't get blue balls. That's not a thing. Like, for me, at least. Like, I can be turned on, like, hard as shit. I could be penetrating.
I'm hard!
And have the woman stop. Call the guard. And have the woman stop. And I'm just like, okay. Like, whatever. I don't feel like, oh my God, I need to get this nut off. I don't feel like nothing. Like, whatever.
Just do it later.
We won't do it at all. That's fine with me. I've stopped in the middle of sex plenty of times because I'm being petty. Like that stimulation, that, you know, that urge that I hear that most men have when it's like, oh my God, we were in the middle of sex and, you know, she had to go and oh my God. Like, what? Relax. Calm down. It's not that serious at all.
It makes sense. Like, obviously, if, like, tension is built up, then it's like, oh, all right, it sucks. But I agree with you. It's like, all right. Like, yes, it's disappointing, but, like, no need to, like, rage out. Like, who's going to suck his dick now? It can't suck itself. Calling a bunch of, like, other options to see if you can, like, just go home and crank it out. Or just...
That's why we need a red light district.
Or be like me. Just suppress your sexual urges until they go away. Okay, I'm laughing because for those of you listening, both of these guys just like went dead face and rolled their eyes because they're like, this bitch. Like,
how dare she even utter those words?
No, but that's literally what I do. Because like people think that like, because I say don't masturbate, that means like I never get horny.
I do believe that.
You believe I never get horny?
I'm not lying to you. I do believe that you do not have any sexual urges ever. Your sexual urge is like, ooh, that guy's fine. It made me tingle. And that's it.
I can't remember who said this. Oh, God, I can't remember. But it was like...
Hugh hasn't moved yet.
It was talking... I don't think he's even blinked. No, it was talking about, like, it was about, like, sex and, like, me talking about sex. And someone's like, Joe has sex?
That's not a surprising question. You're like... I'm glad you think it's funny.
I think it's so funny. Because the answer is, like, yes and no. Like, I don't know how to answer
that. I have...
Like, sex is great. It's cool. I don't...
I just don't want it. I feel like even... Ever.
No, that's not true. I'm
crying. Joe, what do you do when you want to have sex? I go to sleep.
But it's true. No. If I get in the mood and
I... She can't even say it. If I, you know, the eighth letter of the alphabet...
If I get like horny and I'm by myself, like my instinct is like, oh well, like I'm not gonna masturbate.
That's so disgusting.
No, it's like, what?
Because people usually have one of two instincts: masturbate or figure someone. Out how they're gonna fix this issue.
The other issue is that, like, women sometimes tend to get, like, horny on their periods. And then it's like, yes, whether I have a partner or not, sorry, like, I'm not ready for that yet.
Yeah, but your period is only, like, you know, hopefully a couple of days to a week. Anything longer than that, I am so sorry.
By the time the period's over, so
is the horniness. Yeah, you're just like, whatever, forget it.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
But it's like, it's always, like, when your period is, like, furious, that you're just like, damn, I'm really horny.
You
but
always
it's
want
like,
what you can't have, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, and a real man would be like, all right, put down a towel, let's go. Yeah. But it's also, like, for me, like, I'm not saying no to that, but, like, right now, it's, like, you know, like, never say never, but, like, I'm not into the idea
of period sex. While I'm sober and conscious and have a right state of mind, no, right?
I've never, you're implying, like, you know that I had period sex when I was drunk.
No, I
didn't. You're like, but if you're under the influence.
Unappealing. Is it appealing to you?
Fuck off.
No, like, do you think about sex and you're like,
fuck you, because I'm not gonna be painted like a fucking nun. Sex is appealing. The way you talk about sex is
no, I can
appealing.
Understand that. Yeah.
Sex
yeah.
in general, yes, of course. I'm not asexual.
You like to have sex.
Yeah.
You like it or you do it?
I do it because I like it.
Okay.
Wait, is that right?
Yeah.
I hope that's right.
I was going to say I like it because I do it, but no, it's I do it because I like it, right?
Because okay. There's some people that do it that they're like, well, you know, my partner wants to have sex, so I just have sex.
Yeah, sometimes you do it for your partner, but like that's when you're like, oh, I'm just doing it. If you're doing it only for the other person, then you're not going to like it. But like I said, sometimes I get urges, but like a lot of the time, well, yeah, I'm not a super horny person, so it's not like every day or every couple days, for sure. No, yeah.
Once a month at least.
What, because of the whole period thing? No, it's not every time I'm on my period I'm horny, but sometimes it, yeah. I don't know how frequent my urges are. It's like funny because like sometimes it's like the streak is frequent, and then sometimes I'm like,
I don't remember.
I haven't been horny in months. Like, seriously.
I don't even know how old I am anymore.
Fuck, it's been 84 years. Okay.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
My vagina's not dusty.
Fuck you. That brought it too far. As I did it, I'm like, that's not nice. There was no need to do that.
Fucking dust, cobwebs. No, like, it's, you know, she's good.
That's good.
But, like, yeah.
Well, hopefully when you get married, you enjoy sex a lot more.
I mean, hopefully.
Yeah.
See, okay, here's the thing. The issue is not enjoying sex. That's not my issue. Mm-hmm. I don't think I'm, like, the horniest person.
You're by far not.
But, like, for instance, if I think of, like, my two best friends, my two best girlfriends, because I have some close guy friends, but my two best girlfriends, one of them is like, Joe, I don't know how you do it. I could never. And then one of them is like, yeah, I feel you. So, like, people are different, you know? I feel like you're trying to figure out who I'm talking about. No,
I
know.
I didn't even have to figure it out. I already knew right off the bat. Ready knew.
Okay, don't.
I won't. I already knew. And I can say why. The person that's like, meh, I understand.
Why?
I get it. When you do stuff for a long time, it's just, meh, after a while.
No, you know? What? Who said? I think you're thinking of the wrong person.
Okay, then I probably am.
I mean, maybe not. It doesn't matter. But the point is that, like, girls are different. And that's the thing. It's not that either of us dislike sex. It's just that, like,
where it stands on the importance scale isn't up there. Oh,
I farted. Yeah, we all heard. Yep.
That's what I contribute.
What are your thoughts, Hugh, about what I'm saying?
My fart. Nice, steamy, and hot fart.
No, I mean, just tell me how you really feel. It's fine.
I don't. That's why I didn't say anything.
He's like, I was taught that if I have nothing nice to say, don't say nothing at all. Well, actually, no, that's not Hugh, because he would say whether it's nice.
He's not hearing what I said to Kay.
What? Kay was who?
Threesome girl.
Okay, right.
You remember her name.
That's not a name.
You think about... Yeah, but it's the name we gave her. I was telling somebody the story and I didn't remember what we called her.
No, it's the name she gave.
Uh-oh. Of course I remember that. You see how angry I was?
Yeah. That's something that's good.
I'm disappointed. I wasn't angry. I was disappointed.
Yeah, that's true.
What advice did you give her?
Jesus Christ. Memory of a goldfish. Remember she had a threesome? And
no, I know. You said...
I just said you're done fucked up, buddy. You're done, you know what you did was wrong. And
how does that relate to me? I fucked up?
I don't...
How does that relate to me?
I don't
even
know how we got here.
You brought it up. You said, remember the advice I gave to Kay?
Said something about being nice. What? How did we get here?
Hold on. I'm trying to backtrack in my brain now.
We were talking about me, and then I asked Hugh what his thoughts are. He said, I have nothing to say. And I was just be honest.
You said, if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. And he said, you don't remember what happened with Kay.
Oh, that's what you're referring to. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Oh, wow. That's strange.
No, I had a real reason.
Like I don't know. My phone was on Do Not Disturb, but...
Only one person's phone on silent.
Oh, no. I just forgot.
Yeah?
Yeah? I feel like I want to, like, text you just to see if your phone goes.
Text me. Fucking do it. Do it. Fucking text me. See what happens. You know what's going to happen?
Nothing.
That's right.
Hold on.
Because I have you blocked.
Nothing.
Oh, I was hoping that it would at least vibrate
or
something.
I'm only responsible one here.
There you go.
I don't know if I'd go that far. But, yes. So now that I've been thoroughly attacked.
You attacked yourself.
I didn't. We were talking about penis death group. Des was like, "Do you even enjoy
this
sex?"
Blasphemous to me. Blasphemous.
I think it's different. That's my point. Being horny all the time is different than actually enjoying sex. It's like, you know.
No, but I'm not gonna lie. I do feel like you never get horny. I'm not gonna lie. Like, if we're playing a drinking game, like, you know, give a shot to someone who you feel like never gets horny. I would not hesitate. The whole bottle is going to you.
I'm trying to think, because I feel like in certain circles, the shot wouldn't go to me. But, like, I guess I understand why in this situation you would feel
a lot of
way.
People probably feel the same way. They would feel like you really don't.
Well, to be fair, the way I'm painted on this podcast is not great. And it's not just my fault. Because I'll be like, oh, yeah, I don't really think. And then you guys will say it
with confidence. You're like, I mean, I am.
Yeah, but you just called my pussy dusty, and you guys said that if it could make a sound, it would scream. Yeah. So, I mean, that's on y'all. Y'all make me seem worse.
But you laughed at it.
Oh, for sure. It was funny. Yeah, I'm not offended. I'm just saying it doesn't help people's idea and perception
of me. Now they know that it's not that you...
I'm not out here on the streets busting wide open either.
You're not in the car. You're not on the driveway. You might be in your bed.
Am I at least like on the front lawn, standing in the doorway? Like, ooh, fuck off. In my bed. Realistically, that's where I'd prefer to be anyways. But, yeah, okay. So, penis death grip, you feel like not applicable to you.
No.
But you did have to do the Fast and Furious masturbation. But you had a wonderful youth where you were not disturbed.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Nice.
That's planned it out really well.
Nice. So, I don't know if you guys heard. Maybe you did, Daz, Hugh. You probably don't care about this type of stuff. But Quavo from Migos and Saweetie, they were dating for a while. They broke up.
Oh, no.
This story is not about their relationship.
Did you not get her a Birkin bag?
Yeah, probably a few.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, but no. So, I'm not here to talk about their breakup because I don't really care. It's just the fact that, like, a day, I think, maybe a day and a half after they broke up, he sent a repo man to her house to get back the car that he bought her for Christmas. So then there was, like, a big, like, back and forth debate on, like, is it acceptable to take back a gift that you gave someone in a relationship? So I wanted to know. I honestly can't remember. Des, I don't know if you want to, like, look it up and figure it out. But
I will figure it out. But can I go first? Because I was so excited at the end of what you just said. Because, yes, it is fair. Because I feel like, I don't want to say women, but I'm going to say women. If they buy something nice for their boyfriend, their husband, their significant other, I've watched videos where women have stripped the man butt naked on the street because she bought his underwear, his pants, and he was caught with the next girl or whatever, and she's like, it's over, give me your shoes, give me this, give me that, and he has to strip off everything. And I read those comments, and other women were like, yeah, are you stupid? You're not gonna go, you know, some girl's gonna take off this, and I bought this, are you stupid? Of course. And now he's getting his car back. Psh, take the car back. Amen. Hallelujah. Go Quavo. I don't care how rich you are. Get that back.
Whew. But you're saying that because of the actions of some, all should be punished?
All. Yeah. Because vice versa, it's the same thing. Some men do this, but I feel like all men get punished.
I feel, I think I know what you're referring to, because I've seen videos as well where, like, the woman catches a guy cheating. She's like, take off those shoes. Mm-hmm. I bought it for you. Take off those jeans. I bought them for you. Yeah.
I just walked away.
Because probably he feels guilty and
I'll just walk away. I'll deal with that later.
But what about you? Do you feel like it's acceptable to take back gifts in a relationship?
I don't know. I guess like...
Eugene, everyone listening is like...
waiting.
To these weird sounds.
I don't know. Like, in my eyes, all I see is like,
okay, I'm gonna go since you're just making noises.
I guess, I don't know. I guess he didn't really give the gift in, what was the car?
A Bentley.
Yeah, take it back. Take it back, yeah.
No. Well, my question is in not general, just about them, though. My question is a general question.
I don't know. I don't think so. I'll
tell you what I feel.
He bought it for her for Christmas. Sorry.
I mentioned Christmas. Okay. Yeah, I did. I don't feel like it's appropriate. I think it's quite tacky. I wouldn't do it. I understand the want to do it because you're like, fuck you. Like, it's one thing if the breakup was amicable, but if it's like, you cheated on me and I got you all this shit, like, I understand the need. I think the only thing I would ask back for is like stuff that's mine that I left at your house. Yeah. Or like, if I let you use my blank, then like give that back. But like, if it's something that is established, this is a gift, here you go. No, the only thing that I'm kind of like up in the air about is engagement rings. Wedding rings, no, that's mine because we're already married. Mm-hmm. But engagement rings, if the engagement falls through, again, if you cheated on me, fuck it, I'm keeping the ring. But if we break up,
I don't even want that.
Yeah, it's like,
I'm gonna take the ring back, return it.
Huh?
I would take the ring back. I would return it.
Yeah, it's like if we break up just because it's like, you know what, it's not meant to be, or like we're having too many issues, I would give the ring back.
Even if I cheated, I'd still take the ring back.
No, if someone cheated on me, you're going to have to pry it off my cold dead fingers, and I'm going to call my lawyer because it still is my property. Once you give something to someone, yes, for sure. Yeah, like you can't take that from me, sorry.
Unless he's still paying for it.
Then you take someone to court for that?
Yeah. Yeah.
But then you end up paying more money in the long run.
It depends.
I don't really think that's really
bad. Because you can make him pay the lawyer fees if he is at fault.
Really. If he loses, then you paid my lawyer fees too.
Because you, yeah. If he's still...
Like, I was being extra when I said take me to court, but I'm just saying, like, I would put up a fight if the person was like, I cheated on you, but give me back the ring. I'd be like, oh, so you're actually crazy. Like, you're legit out of your mind.
I can understand the need where you're so upset. You're like, yo, give me everything back. So I don't spend that much money on the ring, man. But I wouldn't do it. I can't. Don't tell how you spend. No comment.
Well, no, because most people get their jewelry appraised, so they will find out the value, because you want to insure your ring if something happens to it.
Don't even.
Like... They're just like, insured, they're like, ma'am, this ring is like $20 from Walmart.
Hey, I got that in my Frosted Flakes box.
It's like, girl, it's not even plastic.
You got cool, bitch.
Yeah, like most people, if it's like a decent ring, they're gonna, even if it's not, it's something that's valuable to you. So you're gonna want to insure it in case something happens. So in order to insure it, you got to appraise it. So the woman knows the value of her ring for sure.
Yeah, but if he is still making payments, it's his actually. It's not hers yet. So he can legally get it back.
I think that if you are still consistently, it depends on how long. If it's fresh, then that's one thing. But if you're making payments on the ring, then you should. It's even, probably out of your price range, and you shouldn't have gotten in the first place.
Even with the Bentley,
that was the debate. People are like, if he's still making payments on it.
Oh, it's leased.
He leased it.
Oh, yeah.
I think people are saying it's financed, but either way, it's not paid off. It's not like he bought it.
Yeah, take it back then, because why are you going to pay for someone that's...
It's not even that, because I know how nasty and freaky you are. I know the things we've done in that car. You're probably going to go do that with somebody else. Are you sick with my good money? No,
that's what people were saying as well.
If you're making payments, take it back.
Yeah, people were like... If I were Quavo, I would not want to see her driving around in the car I pay for with another man.
Yeah.
Oh, that's just your own issue then.
I have in the past, like, I bought this girl a necklace. We weren't together or anything, but I bought her a necklace. And I told her, like, if you're going to do something with somebody else, the least you can do is take this off. I don't want the necklace I bought you rubbing up against some next man's balls. Like, and the only reason why I said that is because that has happened to me. How's in the sense.
Rubbing on the balls?
She's sucking dick.
But how's the neck? How it's long are these things balls?
It's swinging.
How vigorous is this bitch? How long's a necklace?
Some people have dangly balls.
Yeah.
Not that dangly where you're.
Oh, you guys right are thinking. Okay, I'm picturing laying down. Sorry, how I like head. He's laying down and she's on top of him.
That's a long necklace.
It's not that long. It's just, you know, just there.
I don't know.
Not if she gets to like the base.
You see.
Not if she's what? Bobble gagging? Yeah.
So that has happened to me. And I asked the girl, like, oh, that's a nice necklace. And she was like, yeah, my boyfriend bought it for me. And I was.
Excuse me?
I was so, so disgusted.
Did you know
her.
She had a boyfriend?
No, I did not. Oh, okay. But it didn't surprise me. I didn't care. But I was just like, how could you? Like, at least take it off.
Yes. Time to get a whore.
You
see,
exactly. You know, you put down your family photo.
Some people
photo.
Have those things. It's like, no, if I take it off, that means like we're broken up. Like, you know, like I'm never going to take
but this instead, off. You're going to let it rub against my cock.
Yeah, because we're still together.
All right. Yeah.
My relationship means something. Not a lot, together. But it means something. How do you feel
about person, like the, what the hell, person wearing jewelry even though they're not in the relationship anymore?
I'm fine with that. Shit, if it looks good, it looks
what
good.
What if it's like that person, you're dating someone and they're wearing the jewelry that their ex gave them? How do you feel about that?
If I'm dating them, it depends. If there's real meaning behind it, because to me, you know, it doesn't matter that it's your ex. If it was a deep connection and this is someone who's been there for you since you were 2 years old, I can understand why you're like, I honestly can't let this go. Mm. It's not that, you know, it's my ex and I want him back. Mm. It's the meaning behind it. I know you're shaking your head because you don't agree with it.
Nope.
But I can live with that. Mm-hmm. But if it was like, oh yeah, my ex bought it. It looks nice. Oh, you think I give a fuck? I give a fuck how nice it looks. But if there's meaning behind it,
that's
I'm okay
so
with it.
That's so crazy because I feel the exact opposite. If it's like, yeah, I just wear because it's nice, then I'm like, cool. But if you're like, oh, my ex-girlfriend got this for me and, you know.
She died.
I'd be like, rest in peace, darling. But
pick it off.
No, if they died, then I'd be like, oh, whatever. I don't care.
I'd be like, you know, like, keep it. Or I guess, yeah, if they pass care. Away, that, I guess that's different.
You're that person because maybe that person helped me become the person that I'm with
yeah,
right
but,
now. So I don't care.
You know how many people I've helped become better?
But what if it's like, okay, what if it's a situation
it
where they were really good friends before? When they started dating, he had got her like something like forever and always type of thing. He has one, she has one.
If the jewelry, to me, the more significant it is,
the
is
more the you more, want it off.
It's disrespectful to your new relationship.
If it's like a Cuban link, I wouldn't really care.
But if it's like, oh, I just wear it because like, oh, it was just like a random gift and it was casual, then like, keep wearing it. I don't give a fuck. But like, if someone was previously engaged and he wears his engagement ring, I don't care if he puts it around his neck, around his ring finger, around his balls. I don't give a fuck. Don't wear it. That's disrespectful.
An engagement ring, yes.
Because it's a significant, doesn't mean it has significance.
Well, it's also an engagement ring.
Well, when he's, exactly, right?
But some people are just like, oh, but it's a nice ring. Like, remember we're talking about keeping rings and whatever? I would keep, if I had an engagement ring or a wedding ring and I broke up with the person, we were married for like 10 years, I'm not going to throw away the ring. What I would do is take the diamonds out and make it a new piece of jewelry. You know what I mean?
I would just sell it.
The whole thing.
I would just sell it.
It's all or none because you still know what it is.
So you just change
whether it. I keep this whole glass or just a shard of it, you know, it still has meaning.
I mean, maybe, but now it's a brand new thing. It doesn't mean what you meant it to be and I just took the diamonds out of it. I mean, whatever. But like, you know what I mean? But it's...
I see why you're saying what you're saying.
When people are like, oh, I think I'm ready to date, but I can't take the ring off. You're not ready. You're still holding on to this person. It's disrespectful to the new person.
So how do you feel if someone gets a tattoo, not of the person, but of meaning, not necessarily their name?
I just wouldn't get a tattoo of the person.
Well, what can you do? A tattoo just is cover stuck it. On the person.
Yeah, just cover it.
But do you feel the same way about it?
I'd say cover it up if you can. If you can cover it up, cover it up. If you can't, oh, it is what it is.
Okay.
What? You have meaningful tattoos?
I have one. I definitely have one.
What is it?
Definitely. It's the heart and the cross.
If you can.
And I got it with meaning on
purpose. What does it mean? Also, you don't have to tell anyone.
Oh, I don't care who I tell because... Like what it means for me if someone was like,
what does it mean?
Like if I'm, I will say,
yeah.
If I'm dating a girl and she's just like, I don't like that, you know, you did, I don't care what.
Well, I don't like you.
Could you imagine?
She's like, we're in a relationship.
So
not anymore, bitch.
One of my exes, I had got her a birthday gift, and it was a heart, a necklace heart. Aww. She had a little cross that her best friend gave her. And I bought her the heart because it was nice. So I bought it for her. And when she put it on, we realized the heart and the cross fit perfectly in each other. Mm. And it was one of those things
Jesus.
Where... No, it doesn't. I pushed it through.
Jesus Christ, so aggressive. Oh.
What? I wasn't aggressive. He was aggressive, moving his hand.
Yeah, so...
What?
Tattoo shop's open yet?
No. It depends where you are, but
not here. No.
So around the time when we broke up, like I was having crazy dreams about her all the time and like couldn't get her out of my mind, and when I did this, it did make me feel...
Oh, you got it after?
Yeah, I got it after we broke up.
Interesting.
And
did she leave your mind?
It did make me feel more at ease. She didn't leave my mind right away. Now she's gone, which is crazy. I never thought this day would come. But we can't even... Yeah, that's a different topic for a different day, because woo, that's a deep one for me.
I like deep.
Oh boy.
Bobble gag.
You like that word, huh?
I learned a new word. But apparently it's not real, so.
But yeah, I just think that if it means something to you and it's nothing crazy like, oh my god, the best sex I've ever had, I can't take this off, take it the fuck off. But if it's something like, you know, wholeheartedly, you know, he saved my mom and this is the ring that my mom gave him, so when he left, he gave me this ring.
But that's not a romantic meaning.
No, I didn't say romantic.
Okay,
I said if it had meaning.
My restriction is a deep meaning romantically.
Okay, yes. Okay, that's fair.
Yeah.
And that's why I brought up, like, if they were good friends before, and this is more like, I love you because of the friendship, and not because of the relationship, you know, intimately.
No, not that one.
The intimately one, no. Okay, then we're on the same page.
What?
I don't know if you're on the trance. Yeah, I didn't know what I should do. I was scared.
That was weird. Hugh, you okay?
Nah, man, I'm dying.
Why? Tired?
Nah, I can smell my fucking hot box.
Oh boy.
What did you call it? My
fucking crotches.
You call your dick a hot box?
It's a box.
And it's hot right now.
Is it a box? I thought they referred to vaginas as boxes.
Well, my dick's a box.
Oh boy.
Dick in a box. Okay, so now we are going to get into a listener question. That's not going to become a thing. You know, you can get really high up there.
I know. I can get to My bass singing voice is tenor.
Let us hear. What's your lowest note? What's your highest? The high one was pretty good. I don't feel like you can actually maintain that.
I can.
Hit the high note and hold it for like 5 seconds.
I feel like it's going to be too much for...
Okay. I can do alto, yeah. Bro.
Okay.
I can
hit that alto. Pretty good. No, that was just your hair. You sound like when that airy one was like when the wind is like whistling through a crack in the window. Not that.
That's the demon.
That's the demon coming through the crack in the window. That's
the demon's coming back.
Yeah, so I'm going to read a question submitted from a listener. And if you are listening and you want to be a part of the conversation, you can write into us at thisquareroom.com/ask. You can write us a question. You can share a story. Anything, really. If you just want to be a part of the conversation and you feel like you have something to contribute, feel free. We want to hear from you. Yep. Thank you, Hugh. Thank you for contributing.
Perfect example.
I would recommend if all you have to say is the word contribute. Maybe you don't, but yeah, thisquareroom.com/ask.
Especially
so today's question, no, it's not. Your long lost son has decided to reach out. Oh. Yes, this question is from Mikey. He does say, just a heads up, this isn't deep or psychological. Yeah, so he says, for this question, you have to go back in time.
I like time.
It is.
it's a good little thing to put in your food. Some thyme.
Oh, like this.
Just chop it up.
Joe, don't even.
I don't think, do people garnish with thyme? Or you, it's something that you actually cook with. Like, you garnish with parsley or like cilantro.
No, thyme you cook with.
Yeah, you don't really garnish with thyme.
No. Just put it in the
yeah.
Just like,
yeah, but you did the motion of sprinkling it on top, like when the dish is already done.
I'm sprinkling it in the oil.
Okay.
Right. Like, and it hits you in the eye, and you're like, ah!
That sounded personal.
Yeah, it sounded like a personal trauma. For this question, you have to go back in time. It is now January 25th, 2020.
What?
The first, it's still back in time, you dipshit.
Man, I was in like 1902.
Yeah, he's like, you are a slave.
That's not funny.
Both of you had very hearty laughs to that.
Yeah, that was enjoyable.
I'd be in the house.
My God.
I'm light enough.
The fuck is wrong with you?
I'm one of the ones they make fight.
Oh, my God.
The real rough and tough, because I'm so big, right? So it's like, no. Like, we don't even want him in the field.
Oh, man, oh my God. You know what I just
My body's built for labor. I think I'd
do you remember when Des told the story about that girl in high school who called him Bubba from Forrest Gump?
Thanks.
I'm so sorry.
It's funny. There's a girl that I told the story to, and she recently watched Forrest Gump, and she called me, and she was like, Des, no, no. And I was like, no, what? She's like, Bubba? And I was like, yeah, man.
Bubba was sweet. He was very sweet.
He was very sweet. Yeah. Yeah.
No. And you don't actually.
Am I dying?
You stop. Stop, guys. We're gonna get canceled.
That's from the soul. That's from the soul.
You know what? That laugh was higher pitched than his vocal range.
Yo, man, it's that Vietnam scene.
You have some untapped vocal range,
bro,
there.
I'm gonna go to an opera coach.
Okay.
And we're gonna see my true potential.
Okay. Oh, you sound like you're singing Ave Maria.
I think that was what he started off with.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I don't know Latin.
Okay, are we gonna get to this question?
Yeah, bro, I'm waiting. We're back in time. It's night last year.
January 25th, 2020.
But why 25th?
He's gonna say if you let me continue. Oh, the first case of COVID has been reported. If you were prime minister, he says, I'm not 100% sure if that's the name of the person who's the leader of Canada.
That's
sorry if I'm wrong. Yeah, you are right.
That was good.
His name's not important.
No. He just doesn't know, like, doesn't, if, like, you know, some people don't know if we have, like,
Joe,
president
Joe,
or
just
prime
keep
minister.
Going. Joe. Yeah.
No, I stand justified in explaining it because a lot of people listening don't know that Canada actually does have a prime minister.
No, but you did explain
and not
it.
A president. No, I wasn't. I was explaining to he. Okay, whatever. See, now I'm not going to continue. He says, what is the first thing you're doing and how successful do you think it would be? So this is January 25th, 2020. You are the Prime Minister of Canada. What is the first thing you do when the first, you know, official case of COVID has been reported? What do you do and how successful do you think you would be?
Band class from China. That was obviously the origin point. Because we were hearing about this shit back in December. Well, I remember hearing it back in like the end of December. So I would have banned flights from China. I don't care about the pushback that I would get. I wouldn't go into lockdown, but I'd ban flights from China.
I don't think you could say you wouldn't, you would not care about the pushback, because as a political figure, you do have to care about how your people...
Yeah, but I have to think in the long run, not in the short run.
That's true.
So I have to think, like, this is China. They're full of shit. This is the Chinese government. They're not really known for being transparent. Also, I'm going to look at... I would have said this. I would have looked at what Taiwan's doing. And Taiwan, they're like, they closed off. They're like, China? What is this? And China's like, oh, don't worry. And they're like, you guys are fucking liars. And they closed off.
You know what's funny? I never heard much about Taiwan and how they handle things.
They closed off. They're one of the first people to just be like... Because they have a big
shit. For how long, do you know?
I think they're probably still closed off.
Oh, shit.
Because they've been fine over there. Because they have
When you say close off, you mean travel-wise. I thought you meant, like, they shut down, like, lockdown. You mean they just
closed off. They're like... Because they have a long, aggressive history with China and shit, right? China's probably going to invade them one day. But, like, once they saw, like, China was like, hey, because...
The difference is, though, like, you have to think about how your country would react. Because, like, even last week, we have people who are protesting, like, wearing masks and, like, all of these things.
This is tough flights.
No, right. But, like, people are not going to like that.
Of course. I don't care. As a leader, you're going to have to do things people don't like. We have to do things for the good of the people.
Or how are you going to force airlines to, like... give refunds and all that stuff.
Airlines don't give a fuck about giving refunds.
Right, so then the people are just out of their money.
Yeah, that sucks. There's gonna be sacrifices. Welcome to the free world.
Right, but like, you want another term. You're literally just taking money from people. But the thing is, I'm
thinking, you have to think of the long... You're thinking of...
Yes, you have to think about at that moment.
I'm thinking of the long term.
Right, but your people aren't thinking that. They're like, yo, what an asshole. Right?
They're going to think you're an asshole no matter what.
I know, I'm just giving you pushback because that's how the people... But no matter what
you
do,
you're an asshole as a leader. You can't please anybody. You can't
please them all.
So I would just close off travel from China because I wouldn't trust them. I wouldn't trust the Chinese government. And then I would do that for now. I'd probably get in contact. I'll try to contact, figure out more information about the virus. I would also contact Taiwan and be like, what do you guys think? And then I'd pretty much copy what whatever Taiwan's doing.
So he also asked, how successful do you think that would be?
I'm seeing what Taiwan did. It's pretty fucking successful. They're good.
See, I feel like the problem... So you mentioned Taiwan. Do they allow flights, like, incoming from anywhere?
I don't... As of right now, I don't know. But at the time... Because
what you think is, some people, they don't fly directly from China. You know what I mean? What if they stop off in another country? So then now their incoming flight is from England. It's from the United States. It's from, you know what I mean?
Well, I would start with China first. And like, then I would see, as cases go on, I would just lock down it from the start.
Well, the question is, what's the first thing you would do? Like,
first thing would be close off flights from China. That'd be the first thing.
Interesting.
If you don't like it, deal with it.
It's not a bad solution, as you mentioned. It clearly worked for some countries. I just feel like... You know, the population is so much larger here, and I would think I would have to...
That large.
Larger than Taiwan.
Is it? I don't think so. I don't know.
I believe so. But I don't know. Like, my first thought would be like, yeah, but like, how many people are...
Barely.
Having direct flights from...
It's 26 million, so it's barely any... It's not that much.
But you get what I'm saying? Like, I'd be like, okay, there's not going to be a lot of people who have direct flights from... China to Canada. Like, there's probably layovers. There's probably people who stop in other places. Are you just farting over there?
Yep.
Oh, God. The fumes are...
Welcome to this fume room.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like maybe my first instinct... I don't know. I'd be tempted, like you said, to, like, just cancel the flights. But I would just postpone all flights temporarily. Whether I don't even know if, like, legally you could do that. I mean, except for essential, right? But, like, you can't stop all travel.
There's a lot of things we thought that we couldn't do, and they did it.
True. In January, to be fair, like, they weren't talking about masks in January.
No one took it serious. Most the Western world didn't really take it seriously until about
maybe
March.
I would consider, like, large gatherings, but, like, to be fair, I mean, I'm not a political leader, so it's hard to say, but, like, it wouldn't have crossed my mind, I don't know, to think about, like, because I remember in March, I went to a Costco, like, March of last year, went to Costco, and like, yes, they were sanitizing like the any surfaces, like the carts and like whatever, and like they said when you come home, like spray down your shit with Lysol, but like nobody was wearing masks in the store, and that's when like the lines were so long that like in the store with like everyone had like their shopping cart ready to check out, but like the lines went all the way to the back and then wrapped back around because everyone was trying to like grab their shit. This is when like toilet paper was going crazy, but like no one was wearing masks, so we're like all in the store just trying to get our shit, but like no one was thinking like, hey, maybe if we wear a mask, like it would.
Well, no one really thinks of masks like that in the Western world. That's more of an Eastern thing. That's more of an Asian thing to wear masks.
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Like, I can't be like, if I'm being honest, I don't know if I'd say like, oh, I'd implement the mask rule right away because like
you wouldn't know shit,
right? Like that's
but
not.
But like I said, I'll just look at Asia.
I would say that large gatherings aren't, you know, are something that I would, you know. Like concert, like when I say large, I would think like scale of like concerts, not like in your homes.
Yeah,
And do I think it would have worked? Probably not, because no, I suck at that stuff, and I would never be a political wiener.
No, I think I would just contact the Asian countries because they have more experience when it comes to this shit. A lot of pandemics tend to start around there anyway. So I'll just contact like, hey, Japan, help.
What would you do?
Not a damn fucking thing. Not a damn fucking.
You wouldn't
thing.
Do anything.
If I'm being honest, no. January 25th, first day we hear about this virus thing.
You'd be like, sucks to be them.
I would be like, damn, that sucks.
But no, but like the first, so if you hear that like, oh, the case is in Canada, you'd be like, oh, it's a one-off. Like,
at that point, I didn't know a damn thing. So like you said, like people are sanitizing, but they're not wearing masks. So it's like, what is the right thing to do? We didn't know this. We don't know that. So at first, we really had no real information. Mm-hmm. You know, a little bit later on, we hear if you have a headache, that's a symptom. A couple months later, they're like, oh, yeah, if you only have a headache, it's no longer like we still don't know nothing as far as I'm concerned. They're just going based off of whatever. So honestly, to me, I wouldn't do anything. The way we handled it, is it good? Not at all. Canada didn't handle it well at all. But I can understand why they didn't handle it well, because do we shut everything down, mass panic, and nothing comes out of this? Like every little, not little, but every virus we hear, are we going to do this for every virus that we don't know about? Like, we're not going to shut this down every time. So let's play it by ear. And if this is the worst case scenario, I would be content with this. Hmm. Not everybody's dead. You know, people will die. If it is it's, what it is. You know what I mean? So by me shutting down the country and everybody backfiring at me, I wouldn't be able to handle that. Like, because what if that's the worst thing I could have done and this was actually nothing? Yeah. And now everybody wants to burn down my house and kill my children.
Oh, God.
Yeah, like, I would just, look, they showed up at their house for masks. I'm telling you to protect yourself and you're getting mad at me? What?
Also, I just want to become a
person. If you don't want to go in the store with a mask, don't. Stand outside the store and complain. But I honestly wouldn't do anything at all. Exactly how we handle it, I probably would have done the same thing.
So, Justin Trudeau.
Yeah, 100%. Piece by piece, I'd go by.
Trudeau.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Mikey, for the question. Not bad
thank
at
you,
all.
Senor.
And again, if you are listening and you want to ask us something, thisquareroom.com/ask. Now, Hugh.
What?
I hate to ask because every time you have something to show us,
Oh, I'm actually allowed to show?
It's not great. But yeah, you said you have a video to show me and Dez. Right. I said I didn't want to see it.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. I think it's the one I sent you.
I didn't watch what you
sent me. I
feel
like that's what it is because I've seen his face.
You can show Dez and then I will.
Did you see it?
I think so.
Oh, okay. Yeah, this thing.
It's crazy.
I feel bad for this.
Yeah, definitely.
Because when I saw it, I was like, ooh, I was like, this is why I just went to calisthenics, man.
Oh, God. Like, just hurry up and show him. I don't want to.
It's the fucking ad, bro. You want to hear it?
No.
You don't really hear much.
No, please.
You don't really close your eyes. He looks like he's about to turn the phone.
Yeah, I'm looking away.
Okay.
Let me turn the volume down. Get to the.
Here, I'm
okay. Should I not describe what I'm seeing?
Okay.
She's like, oh, crap.
I guess, no, for the listeners.
Just, I'm not good at describing things, so it's okay.
Well, you gotta tell them what you're seeing.
Okay, so there's a big white guy, strong. Oh, there's a black guy supporting him.
It's Larry Wheels.
I don't know who
they
are.
This is a gym. Like,
he's
you're in
bench
the gym?
Pressing, yes. He's in bench pressing on the gym, a lot of weights. sorry for the scream. I've seen it already. So he has a spotter behind him, and his spotter is doing his job, and he brings the weight down. As he brings the weight down, it looks like it's too much weight, and his right shoulder, his right breast, I don't know, but it pops.
Ugh. It tears.
Yeah.
His chest popped?
No, it's pretty much what happened is that the pec where it connects from the shoulder here, the tendon, it teared.
And like you can see it pop over to the other side.
Was he shirtless or something?
No, he's wearing one of those shirts.
He's a bodybuilder, so pretty much I hear is that.
I don't like seeing videos.
And he just jumped up so quick because they looked like it hurt.
Yeah, I don't like seeing videos of people in the gym like dislocating things, breaking.
Yeah, this one will haunt you.
That one I felt.
No, I screamed.
Because that's what like when I.
Yeah.
When
by
I,
the way, sorry to interrupt you. If you're listening, I did not scream. That was Des.
Yeah, that was me. Sorry.
I think people might be confused. That was definitely Des.
Because when I was like powerlifting a lot, that was when I would deadlift. That was one thing I was always scared of, is that you can tear your bicep. Mm-hmm. And it pretty much just goes whoop like that. And it's something I was always scared of.
It's funny you say that, because sometimes when I lift weights, my like I can feel my muscles tensing, and I'm like I have to stop.
You're not gonna tear. Well, how much is the weight?
I don't know. Like 20 pounds. You ever? I actually no, not 30? 20. I think I start at 30.
Yeah,
I like to test myself because I'm stupid.
You won't tear anything at 30.
I don't know what I'm doing with weights.
You have to go like up there to really tear something. But then that's always my, like, benching is something I have like little PTSD from, because I fucked my shoulder up benching. But like that, yeah, tearing a muscle is like, because I've strained, like, the worst is I've strained the muscle. I've strained my abs really badly before, and I've strained my hamstrings really bad. And they're, if you strain them, it's hell. When you strain your abs, you pretty much are just like folding, essentially. So, like, whenever I do, like, ab work exercise, like, crunches or weighted crunches, I know the feelings. I'm like, oh, time to stop.
Yep, it's coming.
It's terrifying to, like, you're like, ah! You're pretty much, like, folding in. And I know how to get out of it, but it's, like, it hurts. And then hamstrings, I remember one time at my, where I used to live, their community center at a gym, and I was doing hamstring curls, and I was doing them really, really heavy. And then I stopped because it was hurting, and I pretty much felt like I was going to throw up. And my hamstrings just, it was to the point where I had my mom had to pick me up.
That's cute.
I only lived like 10 minutes away from the place, but I just couldn't. I was just like, my legs. I was like, my legs, mom.
With peace and love, can we change
my hamstrings, mom? I can't. Work your hamstring, kids. That's a very neglected muscle.
Stretch your muscles before and after.
God, yeah. When he teared it.
Okay, yeah, thank you.
Thank God it's sad because, like, he's a bodybuilder, so that's one of those career-ending kind of injuries.
Mm-hmm.
Luckily, Larry sent up a GoFundMe for him, and he got, like, filled in, like, fucking
less than
a day.
Nice. Yeah.
So he's going to hopefully fully recover from that.
Yeah, in the future, Des, don't send me shit like that.
No, now I know.
Like, you hear it, and I'm like, oh, you can slightly hear the tear.
Okay, wonderful, thank you.
And I was just like,
I felt like I saw the video now. But to move on, Hugh, you did say you had a nice little throwback story to share with the class.
Class?
Well, yeah.
Well, I'm sharing shit with a class.
Oh boy.
Fuck class.
Oh boy.
I don't know if I've told this before.
Who cares? We have new listeners.
I might have had. The moral of the story is
Don't. Isn't the moral at the end?
Usually.
Well, the moral's at the beginning. Pretty much don't ever fuck with the little guy, because the little guy will always fuck you up, and the little guy will always have some hidden strength in them. So essentially, I was playing baseball. It was a baseball tournament.
You said you're like a kid?
Yeah, I was like probably preteen or some shit.
Okay.
This was in London, not England, not you fucks.
London, Ontario.
You guys play fucking cricket. London, Ontario. And we'd always face one of the hardest teams was Unionville. They had this fucking one kid who would pitch. It was the most animated pitch, but it was like terrifying, like how he would do it. It was just like he threw his leg up in the air, and it was always so fast. And he was one of those kind of guys that no one could really hit off of him. And like for me, when I was a batter, I was good at batting, but I wasn't amazing at it. Like if I connected, I connected. But this guy, I was just struggling with for like, because he was good. He always would change up and shit. And I think it wasn't bases loaded. I think it was I think there's a person on first and third, and then it was near the end of the game. And then obviously whenever I, cause I was short as fuck. So whenever time I would go up to bat, people always came in. Like, the infielders always would come in. So then, obviously, they come in, and I'm just like, oh, fuck you guys. So then, like, every time. And when I got better at hitting, I was like, oh, you guys better watch out now. But, like, I remember, yeah, they...
Yeah, I feel like that's so disrespectful when they all come in. It is disrespectful.
No, they do it on purpose.
They do it on purpose. You do it to psych with your head. Yeah. But it's like, if you're confident, then you fuck up.
I did that in volleyball.
Dude's coming... yeah. But, like, whatchamacallit? Yeah, the guy pitched. I think I was, like, two strikes. So I was just like, oh, shit. So then the guy pitched. I connected. And it went far. The thing is that when you try to hit a ball, you miss. When you, like, just swing, it always is the most powerful hit. So then I swang. It connected. It was, like, center field. It didn't, because there was a lake. It didn't go to the lake, but it was enough for the guy could actually go and get the ball. So then I'm running. Obviously, third base already gets home. First base, he makes it. I'm running, and it was one of those things where it was, like, it was a close call. Pretty much, I think I can't remember if he threw it to third or something, or threw it home. But essentially, like, we won because of this fucking guy right here.
Nice.
And that's it.
Nice. Oh, so you're the little guy in the story.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
Fuck with me.
Have you ever seen the movie Chicken Little?
Yeah, well...
The sky is falling.
I know the story more than the actual movie.
So
but
that literally what he's saying, that's what I'm picturing, because that's what it was, third and first. And like, I'm just picturing how happy you probably were.
I felt great.
yeah, that's an amazing feeling.
My brother was there. My brother's girlfriend, which I was cool with at the time. Yeah. She was there. And I was just like, he never gave me acknowledgement.
Of course not.
Just be like, that's it. And that was all I got, was a thumbs up. And that was good enough for me. That's how I am too. Yeah. Like, if someone does something, I'm just like, yes. And it's like,
seal of approval.
Yeah. Well, the shaking is like, you did good, you fuck.
Yeah,
that's all I'm gonna do with my kids.
Yeah, you're little shit. Like,
I'm gonna beat your ass. I think he bought me shoes after too.
Oh, that's good.
But yeah, don't fuck with the little kids.
Nice.
It's always
that was like a nice little heartwarming story.
It was.
But I don't recall you ever sharing it on the podcast. Maybe
I've shared a baseball. That was probably when I shit myself.
No, yeah, you shared the story that you had to poop and then the poop was in your pants.
Did I share the one? I can share. Did I share the one where I got hit in the face by a baseball?
No, we'll do that next week. You gotta keep them wanting more. You gotta keep them wanting more because someone else has a story this week.
Who?
Does you're so full of yourself because you know it's you.
It's me.
What's been going on with you lately? What did you say, Hugh?
No, I just feel disgusting.
Yeah.
Yeah, you probably do.
I mean, you're also farting up a storm.
You're
just
sitting in
it. You're literally in like a stink cloud over there. Like,
I am.
You come from work. It was really warm today, and you weren't dressed for the weather suit. Like, you're hot, sweaty,
bro.
And then you're just farting. You're just disgusting over. That's why you sit on a side of the table by yourself. But yeah, Des, what's been going on with you?
So for those of you who don't know and have not heard, my biological father, I do not speak to him whatsoever because I don't like him. I don't like his logics. I don't like how he goes about things. I just don't like him, period. So I found out a couple months ago that I have a 17-year-old sister, or 16 at the time, sorry. 16-year-old sister. Bless you.
Jesus,
he tried to hold it in. That's crazy.
That scared me.
I have a 16-year-old sister, and... He's like, he doesn't know how to get in contact with her, none of that, which I was not here for that. You're a grown man. Shut up. So recently, last week Friday, my mom messaged me and she's like, you know, your sister wants to talk to you. Your dad said, because he can't talk to me, he talks to my mom. Your sister wants to talk to you. You know, she wants to know if she can have your number. So I said, okay, sure. My mom sent me her number. So I was like, okay, whatever. So I add her. And right as soon as I add her, I message her. Her name's Paris. I message her, and I'm just like, Paris! I don't know this girl. Never spoke to her in my life. But I have to come with good energy.
Yeah, but that's too much.
Like, no, though, but that's me.
Yeah,
so
true.
She came back, and she was like, hey! And I was like, yes!
Where is she from? She's American?
She's from Jamaica.
Oh!
So we spoke all of Friday night. I've spoke to her every day since. Like, we talk all the time, and she might be my new best friend, which is crazy.
Aw, that's
now,
so cute.
It really makes me really giddy because I've always wanted a sister. For those of you who know me, you know that I always wanted a sister, which made me want a girl.
Technically, you've had one for 17 years.
But yeah, right? So, like, I talked to her, got to know her, and, like, we are so similar. It makes me uncomfortable.
It's weird.
But it feels so good for someone to understand my train of thought. Yeah. And I was just like, oh, like, what's your favorite thing to do? And she's like, sleep. Like, I don't ever want to leave my bed. And when I leave my bed, I want to go right back. And I'm like, oh my God, that's great. But that's like anybody can want that, right? So she is the positive side of me, or that positive side of me, we share similarities. So I told her that, like, I don't talk to her dad. That's what I said. I'm like, I don't talk to your dad. You know, I've tried. He didn't respond in ways that I like. So I just refused to. And she's just like, you know, you should give him a chance, blah, blah, blah. So she was just like, you know what? Can you do it for me? And I was like, oh, shit. This is the first favor my sister's asking me.
What'd you say here?
I don't know you.
He's not going to call you.
So this is the first thing my sister's asking me. So I was like, you know what? Fine. So I'm like, you have to send me his number because I really don't have his number. So I added him and I realized I had his number, but I didn't save it as his name. I saved it as Guy. And I didn't know who Guy was in my phone because I do know a guy named Guy. So I add him and I send him a message and I'm just like, I want you to know you're unblocked, dot, dot, dot. The only reason why you're unblocked is because of Paris. So you better thank her. And I need you to remember the only reason you're unblocked is because of her. And I made that clear and he gave me a thumbs up. I almost lost my mind. Why? I cannot send you a message saying you're unblocked. If he said okay or all right, a thumbs up, I will slap you.
Okay, hold on.
Go ahead.
First of all, one, it sounds like your father is Eugene.
Look at him smiling.
Yeah, the minute you said your dad said a thumbs up, like I
he's
saw,
like, excellent.
I wasn't even looking directly at Hugh, but I saw the teeth from like the corner of my eye. But to be fair, you haven't talked to him, and
say
like
okay.
every time he says something, it's like wrong, and like no, in the past, right? Like that's why he got blocked. So maybe he's just like, you know what? I don't want to say the wrong thing. I'm just trying to give him.
No, I hear you. You're right.
But also, yeah, if it were you, I'd be like, really? That's all I get? I haven't talked to you in X amount of time, and you give me a thumbs up. So I get it.
Yeah. So so I screenshot that and I sent it to her, and she was like, come on, you don't have to be mean to him. Like he's a really nice guy. I'm like, you don't know him. She only found out about him 2 weeks ago, right?
What?
Yeah, she didn't know, like, at all. Her mom...
Wait, I thought you found out you had a sister a couple
I found out about her,
ago.
But she didn't find out about us.
Whoo! Jesus, who child?
I was also telling her, like, I was kind of telling her the drama in the family of what I know and, like, when it comes to siblings, because we have another sister who is also a long story. She's 12. And I was kind of telling her what I know about the family. And she's like, yeah, that's crazy. So growing up, she went to school with people that look just like her, but were not related. My dad was driving a bus because he now lives in Jamaica.
He does?
Yeah.
Oh, and I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I thought he was in Florida.
So my mom was telling me today that he was driving the bus one day and some girls that I guess know Paris were kind of whispering in the back. And he was just like, are you guys okay? And they're like, oh, you just look like somebody we know. And it happened to be Paris. So she was like, pretty much her whole life, people have been telling her she looks like this person, that person. And that's because our family is really big on my dad's side. I have 48 aunts and uncles. Yeah. Thank you, right?
48 aunts and uncles. So that means that your grandmother on that side have 48 kids?
No, my dad. My dad's dad sticks his dick in everything.
Yeah, so that your grandparents on that side had a lot of kids.
No, not
grandparents.
Yeah, there we go.
One of them,
yeah.
But still.
Yeah.
Ooh, okay.
So, 48. That's crazy, right?
Damn. There's a lot of y'all.
So that means you are...
I'm Jamaica, yeah.
Your family
yeah.
is Jamaica.
Years ago,
yeah, so you're the whole island.
Years
got
ago,
it.
My aunt told my mom to tell me, like, now that you're a big man, like... Be careful when you go to Jamaica. You don't know.
If you're listening 48. And you are in Jamaica or from Jamaica or have family there, I probably have your cousin here.
Come get
reach
him.
Reach out to thescarerroom.com if you
want. 48.
Wow.
But I've been
and
really.
And then they all probably have kids.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like, so I asked him. So Paris is now 17 and I'm 27, I think. Yeah, 27.
Yeah.
I always get confused. And
yeah, I forgot to.
I asked him today how many, you know, cousins would I have between Paris's age and my age. Mm. And I said roughly, because I know he doesn't really know. So he said roughly he would say around 20. So I asked one of my aunts who live in Canada, and she said honestly, she would go closer to 30 or more.
What?
And I was just like my mind is boggled. Well,
because when you told me 48, what popped in my head was 30. Because I'm like, if all of them even have, or not even
have
all of them.
One,
if,
two, if yeah.
half to a little over half have like a couple, mm-hmm. then, yeah. you know. Yeah.
And it does make sense, but it's, I don't like that simply because I've always wanted like a big family reunion yeah. kind of thing. Like I wanted to be I've close to cousins.
And I would love that.
The cousins up here, like they are my cousins because of marriage. But I'm like, you're not my cousins. Like, it's not the same. Like,
oh, you want like blood cousins?
Yeah. So now that I'm talking to Paris, that was pretty good. But now that I'm talking to Paris, like, it feels good,
yeah, that's good.
To talk to somebody who kind of gets it, especially on that side. Yeah. And like we were just talking about the fact that if we did have like a big family function, the two of us would just sit there and talk shit mm-hmm. about everybody else. She seems pretty cool. It's like talking to myself, which is great. Like, yeah, I'm really happy because now I can talk to her sister.
No, when I met my sister, it was really weird because we're very similar. Mm-hmm. I was like, what the fuck? Because she played baseball also. And mm-hmm. I was like, what the fuck? And the way she talked, I was like, hey, what? We're the same.
You know when you go back and forth with somebody on text message, like you're having fun. Oh, I was going to call it banter. Like you're just having fun. And I know, but I was going to call it for a different reason. And like, let's say Joe sends you an angry face emoji. You send a different, you guys go emoji for uh-huh. emoji. So I sent her a GIF, those little sticker things on, what are they called? GIFs.
Yeah.
So I send her a GIF.
One that was moving?
Yes, yeah. yes. Mm-hmm. So she sends me a GIF back. Mm. And I was like, I don't like that because yours is better than mine. Mm. So I sent her, we did that for about 30 minutes. Just GIF for GIF. And I was like, nobody else would do this. This is fucking great. Mm. But yeah, so I have a sister. I'm very giddy because, and that's why when you asked me how I'm doing and I said great, it's really because of her.
That's nice.
She has like a little YouTube channel and I watch a couple of her videos and she is, I don't want to say she's so funny, but I see the outgoingness.
Oh my God, when you're done, I want to see.
I'll show you, yeah.
Does she like resemble your side of the family?
I don't know that side of the family. Because
you are like a spitting image of your dad. That's what I mean, though.
Oh, okay. Like, she looks more like.
Thought your dad was you when he was a baby or whatever.
People say, like, my mom is telling me, like, yes. I don't really see it.
I'll be the judge.
But I do see that she looks like our other sister, kind of. Like, they resemble each other, like, in the mouth, nose area. Well, I'm sure
she's beautiful.
And, yeah. So, when you asked me how I was doing, and I said, I'm great, this is actually why.
Yeah, that's awesome. I love that. Both of you told such nice stories, and I told a story about a stalker. That's not...
yeah, what the fuck, bro?
You guys could have told me that, like, we're going the happy route today. I have nothing happy to talk about.
And I told him, like, I messaged my dad, and I'm like, I need you to understand that for some reason, this girl has faith in you. I told her you are stubborn. I told her that you are stuck in your ways. I told her that, like, you really don't like to listen to people and you only see one way. And for some reason, she keeps vouching for you. I don't understand it, but you better do right by her at least. And he was like, he said some Jamaican words, but he was just like,
that's
not a word.
And he was just like, you know, of course I will. And you're gonna be sorry that you doubted me type of thing. Mm-hmm. And I was like, when you slip, you slide. Cause it, pretty much, like, if you lose her, I'm gone, because I'm the only, she's the only reason I'm talking to you.
Sorry, that one hurt me.
And I screenshot that, and I sent it to her, and she was just like, Dez, like, can you not be mean to him, please? I need you to give him a chance. I'm giving him a chance. Like, I'm not mad at him. He didn't know about me. And I'm like, I know, but, like, you don't know the history I have with him. And she's like, I know, but, you know, he's getting old. And she's vouching for him, and I understand why. And as I'm reading it, like, as she's sending it, I was smiling, because this is what I would tell somebody else if I wasn't me. And the fact that she's saying it to me, for me not to listen, is like me giving people advice that I wouldn't take. So I needed him to know that she's the only reason why. So she made me make a deal with her that I have to be nice for him for 3 weeks at least. So he's been messaging me, how's your day? How's work going? And I'm answering. I'm like, how are you? Oh, how's your... Because he's raising chickens and pigs and stuff like that.
So your dad is Hugh?
Hey man, introduce me to this guy.
Yeah, that's why he has so many kids. He wanted someone to take care of his chickens.
Shit.
Yeah, and he's like, oh, why don't you just buy a goat, a ram goat, so that I can raise it for you. And I know your mom likes to come down in December. And then, you know, when you guys come down, you guys have something to eat and I'll make sure it's good. And I'm like, no.
Oh, take the goat, bro.
I don't care for him.
But the goat.
I am keeping it at a level. No.
No, but the goat's good, bro.
Fool me once. Shame on me.
Just take the goat.
No.
The goat's fresh goat.
You want me to pay for the goat?
No, don't pay for it.
And I know what he's going to do. That's what he wants. Me to pay for the goat. For him to raise the goat and take care of it for us to have. However, what you're going to do is take my good goat, fuck out my goat. You're going to fuck out my goat and have little...
My good goat.
Yeah. You're gonna fuck out my goat, pour out my goat,
And my goat's gonna have babies.
So the babies are your babies, and I get this one dega goat that's now fuck out. Nah, man.
I don't like the way you're phrasing that. Fuck out my goat. I don't like that.
I'm just saying.
I understand what you're trying to say, but like, I don't like that. Fresh goat, bro. But you know what? But, for whatever reason.
And I spoke to my and
it's nice.
Thank you.
Especially the sister part.
And I want to get like I actually want to know that side of family. I just didn't care to because like my dad was so stupid about the whole thing. But now I have another insider,
right?
Which is great because I have an aunt.
Because you don't even need to get to know exactly. Them through him. You have her.
I have her, and she can tell me who's good and who's not. Yeah. And like I said, she has met some of them already without knowing that's her family.
Oh shit!
So she's not even thrown back by it. And her analogy for life is just like, it is what it is.
It is what it is.
And I'm glad she has that, but how she got that, I wish that wasn't the case. Because, I mean, for those of you who don't know and didn't listen to the last time I talked about this, she got into a bus crash in Jamaica. And on one of her YouTube channels, she talks about it.
Oh, this is the same sister. Yes. You did mention this.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So... when she talked about it in her YouTube channel, and I'm picturing everything. And when I say I was at work and I'm tearing up because I'm like, oh my God, my sister, and I didn't even know she could have died. Oh my God. Like, I wasn't crying like that, but I mean, like,
everything happens for a reason.
Yeah. And she was like, when she was saying it, she was like, you know, I'm not mad at anybody. Because when she tells the story, there's a series of events that could have prevented her from being on that bus. Mm-hmm. And she was just like, I'm not mad at anybody, you know. I'm not mad at the driver. I'm not, you know, it is what it is. I'm here now. There's somebody that did lose their life, unfortunately. But that's life, right? It wasn't my time. It's not my time. And I'm like, oh, I would have been mad at everybody.
That's really nice. And, you know, I guess all you have to do is keep faith that...
keep moving
although
forward.
You didn't have the best of your father... maybe she'll get the best of him.
There
though.
Is no best of him. Oh, yeah, no, there's no best of him.
No, like, you know what I mean? Because yeah, you said that part of her argument was, oh, you know, like, he's getting older and da-da-da. Mm-hmm. And, like, some people do realize their ways once they get older. And
I asked him for a favor.
What's the favor?
And I've never asked him for anything my whole entire life. What, nothing.
What'd you ask him?
I asked him to make her a seafood boil. Is that what it's called? So she really loves seafood, and we were talking about it. And I told him, I'm like, oh, told her, like, your dad's a very good chef. Like, I won't lie about that. She's like, yeah, my mom told me, blah, blah. I'm like, oh, like, you know, he's really good at making seafood, too. So you should ask him to make you, you know, what you want. And she was like, oh, I really want a seafood boil. I'm like, yeah, so ask him. She's like, you know, I just met him. Like, I'm kind of shy. Like, I don't want to, you know, can you ask him for me? I'm like, oh, damn straight. You think I give a fuck about this guy? So I messaged him. I'm like, can you do me a favor, please? And I never asked him for anything. And I threw that in there, too. And he was just like, sure. I'm like, Paris is, you know, Paris wants a seafood boil. So I need you, the next time you see her, to bring her seafood boil.
All right. You need to.
Hmm? I think it's just like a whole bunch of seafood, like shrimp, crab. Like just
season up really well. And you ever like Captain's Boil and you see them put on the shit and
oh, it's just that shit.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
So he was just like, okay, yeah, I can do that, but not the next time I see her because I think I'm seeing her tomorrow. I was just like, whatever. I'm not gonna lie to you, I really don't like talking to him. Like, I cringe. Like, he was asking me how work was going and I was cringing answering him, and I 100% am doing it for her. And
wait, so that means you've been talking to her a lot, because if you only started talking to her on Friday and today's Monday.
I've talked to her every day, every second. Like, as I was coming up here, I'm messaging her. Like, we message all the time. And she has two older brothers and two older sisters. The closest to her age is 22, And she told me but she's...
Those siblings are not your dad's.
No.
So she's your only actual sibling. Okay, got
so
it.
So she was like, she's the outcast. Like, she's the black sheep of the family. She always felt kind of left out of everything. And she was like, even talking to you for 24 hours, I've told you more than I've told any one of them. I'm like, oh my God, this is all I ever wanted.
That's really nice.
Yeah, so that's
that
my story.
That makes me happy, Des.
That's good. It makes me happy, too.
Yeah. That's wonderful. Hugh, your story also was very nice and had a very sweet message. I'm proud of you both.
Thanks.
Oh, God.
All right. Daddy wasn't there.
Careful.
No. I was adjusting myself. I didn't move.
Can I get
chair.
A fish, Dad?
His head flew up. Okay. So that brings us to the end of our episode. We appreciate you guys for listening. Where can they find you, Eugene?
You can find me at
in the jungle.
HUGHGENEB at Instagram.
And Des, where can they find you?
You can also find me on Instagram at DesiD18.
Honestly, I thought you were going to say you can also find me in the jungle.
Not me. Not with those mosquitoes.
The jungle right now.
True.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, and you can find me on Instagram at Jonelle Wilson, JonelleWilson, and also on Twitter, same handle. And of course, you can find our podcast at This Square Room on Instagram, Twitter, all of that. And that's about that. I think I didn't leave anything out. Nope.
No.
Just, you know, tell a friend about the podcast. We would really appreciate it. And Please. Don't forget to leave us a rating and review on iTunes. That would go a long way as well. Thank you guys so much for listening, and we will see you next Tuesday.